A well-sculpted clay figure can add festivity to the atmosphere, not only as a decorative item, but also as a symbol of luck.
This reminds me of a handicraft cloth that I used to take when I was a child. And after the paper cutting, today I'm gonna try to make a clay figure this time. Okay, let's just learn from professional master.
Nirang 最开始创始人是叫张明三。 因为他做的东西惟妙惟肖，老百姓对他的艺术认可，后来就给他起泥人张。他一生做了将近10,000多件作品。10,000多件，那要是每天做一件，感觉也得做30多年。对对对对。
You can't make bricks without straw. The quality of clay figure depends on the quality of the raw material.
咱们这个泥是什么材料的呀？这个泥啊，是天津的胶泥，这泥里要加棉花。 为什么要加棉花呢？主要是增加这泥的这个拉起来不断。中国传统做神像最后加棉花，主要是加强它那个凝固的能力。Both
of us are using our hands, but the clay is coming alive under those hands.
一般的头比例啊，行七坐五蹲四盘三，站起来要7个头比例，坐下5个头比例，蹲着。 4个头比例，盘腿3个头比例。今年不鼠年嘛，所以做个老鼠，大家恭喜发财。哎，从老鼠从那个元宝里钻出来，先做个头，再做那个它五官。头做以后，才做身子。您这脑袋前头上，是在后面的前头。
这是
啊，对，这不是。
这是嘴。
把手做完以后。 整个彩塑就做完了，对。要做一件作品，就这样，要观察生活，要记在心里，变成形象的东西，有那么个过程。Real
life is a source of clay figure Zhang's creation. Constant breakthrough innovation is a secret of the art's enduring popularity.
过去老泥人张他都不烧制，你做那手。 你要不烧，特别容易折，那么细的东西一蹦蹦的。后来我就想啊，反正烧制以后，这泥人就好了。烧制以后有什么好处呢？它结实了，坚固了。这个天津传承的为什么好呢？就因为不断的出现好作品。当时我就18岁吧，那阵儿特别喜欢苏联的那个雕塑，我呀就做了一个搬石头的一个农民。 在太原走在那个街上，突然看一个报亭，在美术杂志的最封面登了我这作品，哎呀，特别荣幸，也对我今后的创作起了一个非常大的一个鼓舞作用。哎。When
the final color is done, vivid clay figures will be completed. They retain the most common costumes of the land and add festivity to the solemn atmosphere.
The mouse that Master Lu made is really cute. Let's place it in a good spot. The one that I made, let me just place it in a doorway to ward off the evil spirits.